Okay, so this is going to be a complete basic rundown of the decode process. So here we have our RF capture, which is a Domesday duplicator demo tape example. So we have the 40 million samples per second file from the Walking Around Garden Monday demo tape, and it is VHS slow play. So this is also a PAL tape, I should also note. So we're going to copy this, so we've got that on our clipboard. Now the file's already in this directory as well, but we have decode.exe, ld-analyse.exe, and tbc-video-export.exe. Decode.exe is your combined set of decoders, ld-analyse is your universal cross-platform analysis tool, and then you have tbc-video-export, which handles the piping between the TBC files, the tools, and your final FFmpeg-generated video file. So let's go on here, on the terminal, and as you can see, I've already typed decode.exe --help, because most people will feel lost at this point and just assume it will magically work. Because it is several decoders combined into one exe, you need to actually state which decoder you want to use. So the options are VHS for tape, CVBS for composite video, LD for Laserdisc, and HiFi for HiFi FM audio. So let's go decode.exe, VHS, and let's do tape format, VHS, and then let's do system PAL 8. Let's go thread 6, because the decode software can't actually use more than 6 threads currently. And now we put our input name and our output name without the extension. And by hitting enter, we begin the decoding process. And now that we've got over 100 frames decoded, we can now go on another tab and open ld-analyse. Now a trick here is to do --style-fusion, which enables the QT flag for doing dark mode, and we give it an input.tbc, and voila! We have our Y plus C data. And we also have dropout data. As you can see here, a slight dropout will show up with a highlighting, but this will also be masked with the export of the video file. So we can also go and open up stuff like the black SNR analysis. That's a good starter. This will show you the black signal-to-noise ratio based off of the empty side of the frame, or the VBI area, which is a great general assessment for the noise level of a capture and decode. A very poor capture will have a very loud amount of noise, or a very low black signal-to-noise ratio. Now we also have access to a vector scope, which opens in another window. There we go. And as you can see, as we go through the image, it changes the waveform. Now the vector scope is more helpful with color bars, because we have access to video parameters and video dichroma decoding. So parameters will just manually set the 16:9 or 4:3 aspect ratio. That's literally all this particularly does at this point. Whereas we have... There we go, our chroma decoder. Now if we make this smaller, we can show the chroma decoder. Expand, contract, and if we change the chroma phase, we can see it rotate and the colors shift. So you have a very high degree of control at the chrominance decoding level with the PAL 2D color decoder, transform 2D, transform 3D, and you also have 1, 2, and 3D decoders for NTSC. And now our decode has finished, we can now finally export a video file. So we can go to our third window and do tbc video export exe, and then we can copy our tbc name. And by default, this will make a standard FFV1 10-bit file with 422 chroma subsampling and FLAC compressed audio, if there is an audio file available to be muxed. And now that the video encoding is finished, we can go and open our final exported video file within the decode folder. And that's it, a standard YUV video file is produced.